Judge Scalia, right? Is that his name? So Judge Scalia, when this issue of Roe versus Wade came before him again, basically wanted to overturn the judgment that had been made at that time to overturn Roe versus Wade, which gave, said that basically a woman has a right to have an abortion versus the inalienable right given to us by a creator, that we have a right to protect life, the life of the separate DNA unborn child in our womb. He said, but I wanted to support it, but where was the moral outcry? And something I think you hit, and you hit so well, Frank, is you say, we've been silent too long. And Rick, you're bringing this too. You say, the church has just been silent too long. And I think part of it, we don't know what to say, right? Part of it, we don't want to come across as judgmental, but the reality is we can't tolerate everything. But what does it look like? We have to grapple with the realities of what does it look like for us to speak the truth, right? And say, yeah, some things aren't acceptable, and be okay to say, just that we don't have to be tolerant to be loving. Those two things aren't necessarily the same thing, right? That being said, that's my testimony. I think we're going to share that primarily so that, for two reasons. Number one, because it is the greatest human rights issue we're having in America right now. Number two, because whether you're Christian or not Christian, can everyone agree that it's wrong to murder children? Okay? It's impossible to look at that picture that shows somebody and say that's not a baby. Because it is. And having done what I did, I can say this to you. We're not here to condemn anybody, but we're here to tear the deception off and the propaganda off the eyes of the American people so that we can shift our nation back into a place where this top moral right of life is sacred.